going on? It is Christian Meals with UltraTV here with the one, the only car hopping Tom Swoon. What's going on? How's Miami?
Yo, man, I think Miami is crazy. I mean, it's my first time here and I simply love it here.
No way.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I'm considering a few places to move, like, because I live in quite the middle of nowhere, yeah, you know, in Poland. So basically, Miami is one of the places definitely to visit next time.
Yeah, well, that's actually a question I was asking someone earlier is, if you had a list of five destinations you could go in the world that you've never been, where would it be?
I think London, LA, Miami, maybe India, just to, you know.
India would be cool, yeah.
Really, I was there before with Steve Aoki, like later the tear, and it was amazing, you
yeah.
know. They just know what's going on, so simply I was surprised and amazed.
Yeah, absolutely. I see a lot of the big DJs are really embracing you. Obviously, you have people like Avicii, and you've got people like Hardwell and all these guys that are kind of really just bringing you into the mix and pushing your music. What does that mean to you to have those people supporting you?
Really, I mean, I first support I've received, like, from Gareth Emery, you know, David Guetta, Tiesto. I was so amazed, you know. It's like I didn't even expect, you know, for this to happen, because right now, just 1 month ago, 2 months ago, I released a remix for Bloody Beetroots, Ultra/D-Mac. Yeah, and it was out, and for 1 week, nothing. For second week, nothing. And then apparently, immediately, like, support from David Guetta, Arty, Gareth Emery,
right?
You know, everybody. I was, like, sitting at home, I was like, what's going on? Really, you know, it's like huge smasher, you know, been hitting all the main stages, you know, all over the world.
Yeah.
I was sitting at home watching it at YouTube, you know, like 10,000 people, crazy stuff, you know, and really recommend it to everybody. It's like, and you're never getting used to that, you know.
Yeah, absolutely.
Even the next year, 2 years, you know, when somebody's big gonna support my tune, I'm gonna be happy as I'm happy now.
One thing I always like asking DJs is, what's your software and hardware setup and how has it evolved? You know, what did you start out on and what do you mix with, what do you produce with?
I'm quite a bedroom producer even right now, because I'm living in the middle of nowhere in Poland, and I'm still, you know, living with my parents. You know, I'm going back to my room, just walking out of the bed, making 5 feet, you know, of distance, sitting at the desk, you know, getting out the keyboard and producing. You know, it's a flow, you know, because I feel this is a quite noise, like quite silent place, you know.
Yeah.
And I'm just, you know, sitting there, you know, there's nothing happening, totally nothing, you
yeah
know? It's like, if one car passes by per day, it's a fucking celebration. So basically it's
one car.
Yes, seriously, it's like totally middle of nowhere. They're even lowering up the asphalt, you know, for the night.
Damn.
So basically it's like, you know, so totally silent, empty place, so I have the time, you know, to focus myself, just, you know, meditate and stuff. So
a little zen time.
Yes, zen time. And I'm pretty focused, you know, on the music. That's the thing, you know, because when I'm touring, I have no time to produce.
Of course, yeah.
And stuff.
Who can we find on your iPod? Who are you listening to?
You know, I'm listening to all stuff of music, like from, you know, dubstep, drum and bass, chill step, you know, progressive house, electro house, you know, some funky shit, like, you know, Michael Jackson even and stuff, Daft Punk. And even like now, I've realized that I find inspiration in stuff I don't make. So basically, I'm not listening to progressive house to get an inspiration.
Sure.
I'm listening to stuff like film scores, you know, soundtracks from films, from games.
Nice.
Right now, I have the soundtrack from Far Cry 3, for example.
Yeah.
Like, I'm just getting inspiration from the stuff, you know, because basically, you know, you can get these ideas like melody, how it's arranged, you know.
Sure.
You can get it, you know, and transfer this to your style.
Yeah.
It's really amazing.
If you could do a collaboration with any artist that's no longer with us, that's passed, somebody, one of the greats, who would it be?
I think it would be Michael Jackson.
Michael Jackson.
Definitely, like, he's a huge inspiration, you know. It's like, and even, you know, the thing, it was like, he had like these long video clips of 7-8 minutes, you know.
Yeah.
And I'm like, you know, it's really,
it's
I love
Thriller and all that stuff,
yes,
with like the 5 minute intros and stuff.
When a video has a story, you know, I love it, you know. I don't want, I never ever, hey! Ultra, baby! You know, I hate the videos with like the naked girls like dancing, there are no sense, you know. And I love the videos with a story, you know, after the video you saw the video and like, whoa, like, what the fuck just happened?
You talk to your fans as if they're your friends, you know what I mean? You address the camera, you're talking about the places you've been to, you did the 2012 wrap up, I think you said what, 40, 50 cities or something like that?
It was a lot of cities, a lot of flights, you know. For the kid like me, like 1 year ago, I was sitting at home, you know, producing my stuff. I was like only watching the videos from the other DJs from tours. I was like, oh!
Yeah.
And I was still, you know, having my exams, you know, because I was finishing, I was in the final class of high school.
Sure.
And I was like pretty high school kid, you know, watching this shit. I was like, what the hell, I want to live this life, you know, it's my dream. And right now it's happening, you know, and I'm really pretty getting used to it. And I love, you know, and but sometimes when I sit down, you know, back in the hotel, back at home from the road, I'm like, what the hell just happened, you know? I'm like, wow. Pretty, you know, impressed by everything. And I'm still, you know, it's a pretty new thing to me, but I'm, you know, even before they ever set, you know, it doesn't matter if it's like 400 people, 4,000 people, you know, it's like I'm always like stressed at the same amount. Yeah. I'm like just having this stomach thing, like before sitting in the roller coaster, I'm like, what to play right now, you know?
Obviously, with all the energy you have, you seem like an adrenaline kind of guy. Yeah. Bungee jumping or skydiving?
I think both.
you're gonna bungee jump from an airplane, and then after you go back and forth, you're gonna cut your cord.
Cut the line, and then you'll shoo, parachuting. I really, you know, I'm pretty much into extreme stuff because I used to ride skateboard for like 2 years. And I really like this dose of adrenaline, you know. Even if I'm gonna spread my ankle, I don't care, you know.
Yeah.
It's the risk you approve to take, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, baby.
Woo!
Later.